Hey, students! Hello! Come here! Good morning, my students from 5th A grade and 5th B grade. How are you today? Are you happy? Are you active? Excellent! Now we are going to start with the Unit 2. And the name of the unit is The Place Where I Live. This is the Lesson 3. The ability is writing. The objective is number 14. El objetivo número 14 dice usar vocabulario de las partes y objetos de la casa, rutinas del hogar y preposiciones de lugar para completar y escribir un texto de acuerdo a un modelo y con apoyo del lenguaje visual. Section 1. Setting the context. Vocabulary. Observe the image and answer what home routine or activity you had been doing during this pandemic. This family has been cooking. What is your routine for this pandemic? In my case, I had been studying. Second activity. Observe the image about home routines and finish the sentence with the information about you. Use phrases from the box. The phrases from the box are in my bedroom, in the kitchen, in the living room, in the dining room. Activities: do my homework, do the dishes, work on the computer, watch TV, chat with my friends. Third activity. Write a sentence in correct order. Escribe las oraciones en el orden correcto. Example. Always do I my homework. Ordeno esta oración y me queda. I always do my homework. Muy importante. Primero el pronombre. Adverbio de frecuencia. Acción o verbo. Y complemento de la oración. Completen ustedes. Siguiente actividad. Es solo de observación. Entiendan. Y si no entienden, me preguntan cuando nos juntemos en la clase. Observe this preposition of place that indicate where the ball is. In front of. El balón está frente a la caja. Y dice, the ball is in front of the box. En la segunda imagen, el balón está al lado, está próximo al cajón. Y dice, the ball is next to the box. Tercera imagen, el balón está entre los dos cajones. The ball is between the boxes. Cuarta imagen, el balón está sobre la caja. The ball is on the box. Y en la última imagen, el balón está inserto, está dentro del cajón. Y digo, the ball is in the box. ¿Entendieron las preposiciones? Más o menos. Bueno, vamos a practicar las más nomás. Ahora les invito a ver un video justamente sobre este tema. Observemos.
Smile and learn. Hello, friends. Today we're going to learn words that tell us where things are. Our friend Chester will help us. Where is Chester? Chester is in the box. He's in it. The cat is in the box. And now, where is Chester? Chester is in front of the box. He's in the front. The cat is in front of the box. Where is Chester? Chester is next to the box. He's next to it. The cat is next to the box. Where is Chester now? Chester is under the box. He's under it. The cat is under the box. Where is Chester? Chester is on top of the box. He's on top of it. The cat is on top of the box. Where is Chester? Chester is between the boxes. He's between them. The cat is between the boxes. In the box. In front of the box. Next to the box. Under the box. On top of the box. Between the boxes. Let's see how you'll be getting out of there, Chester. See you around.
Do you want to keep on learning? Try for free our Smile and Learn platform for a month and enjoy all of our games, videos, and interactive stories. Go for it! Download Smile and Learn on your mobile, tablet, or PC.
Section 2. Let's practice. Where is it? Number 1. Activity number 1. Observe the Cárcamos family's house and complete the sentence with the missing information. Use the vocabulary of the part of the house and preposition of the place. Observa la casa de la familia Cárcamo y completa las oraciones con la información que falta. Usa el vocabulario de las partes de la casa y preposiciones del lugar. Ejemplo, Joaquín is in the kitchen. He's next to Carola. En esta parte unimos todo lo que estamos aprendiendo. Partes de la casa, preposiciones. A trabajar ahora. This activity is easy for you. Number 2. Observe the house and write sentences about where the people are in the house. Use the vocabulary of parts of the house. Observa la casa y escribe oraciones sobre dónde están las personas en la casa. Usa el vocabulario de las partes de la casa. Te dije que era fácil. Mira. Roberto. Roberto is in the... Number 2. Luis. Luis is in the... Rosa. Rosa is in the... Marta, Marta y Cindé, tú continúas. Section 3. Let's contract and apply our knowledge. Where is the object? Activity 1. Write the preposition from the box that indicate where the object is in each match. Escribe la preposición del recuadro que indica dónde está el objeto en cada imagen. Preposición. Next to, between, in front of, on. Ahora completamos las oraciones. The shower is in. The couch is the table. The couch is to the plant. The plants are the desk. The table is the chairs. Continuamos. Activity 2. Complete the chart to indicate where the people are. According to the image, use a preposition of place from the vocabulary. Completa el cuadro para indicar dónde están las personas de acuerdo a la imagen. Observa mi ejemplo. Name, Lori. Preposition, next to. Ella está próxima al ladito del refrigerador. Object, fridge. Muy importante escribir la oración. Lori is next to the fridge. Jane and Carol, coach. John, Carl and Ann. Mark, the kitchen. Ben, Alex. Ustedes tienen que completar con las preposiciones que pueden ser in, on, between, in front of, next to. Ustedes verán. Section 4. Sponge activity. Count and write the name of the number. Cuenta y escribe el nombre del número y del objeto. Example. 10 students. 2 coaches. One girl, four television, tables, chairs, beds, balls, boxes, plants. Ahora sigues tú. Mis niños de quinto A y B, esta ha sido la entrega de esta semana que corresponde al mes de noviembre. La semana es del 9 al 13 de noviembre. ¿Cómo estuvo la actividad? ¿Fácil? ¿Difícil? ¿Ni fácil ni difícil? Bueno, a los que se les hizo difícil y a los que no se les hizo difícil, recuerden que el miércoles 11 de noviembre a las 12 horas nos estaremos encontrando para reforzar todos los contenidos y las actividades de esta cápsula. Y después de eso, no olviden enviarme sus respuestas a mi correo o a mi WhatsApp. Les espero. Goodbye.